Hi, I'm Dr. Chris Masterjohn of chrismasterjohnphd.com, and you're watching Chris Masterjohn Lite, where the name of the game is details, schmetails. Just tell me what works. And today we're going to be talking about how to get over that afternoon crash. Here are a few tips that I have. Number one, eat a meal for lunch that is relatively modest in size, relatively high in protein, and relatively low in carbohydrate. And what I mean by that is 30 to 40 grams of protein, 10 to 20 grams of carbs, and fill the remainder with fat. Make it just large enough to take the edge off of your hunger and no more than that, and make sure it's foods that you digest well. The reasons are protein stimulates the waking signal in your brain, carbohydrate shuts it down. Now, of course, when you wake up in the morning, you may feel like carbs wake you up a little bit, and that's because you need to get your blood sugar up. But in the afternoon, when the waking signal in your brain is already taking a dip because maybe we're hardwired to take a siesta at that time, and then we throw a bunch of carbohydrate on it and dip even more, and when we've been working all day and so the pressure to need some sleep is building, that can be the perfect storm to make us crash in the afternoon. So that's the time when you want to try to up the protein, take away some of the carbs, and of course you don't want the meal to be so full that that weighs you down, and you don't want it to be things that you digest because then you're going to direct your energy towards digestion. Now that's step one. Step two is a cold shower. I take a cold shower almost every morning, and I don't usually take one in the afternoon, but on rare occasions when I'm feeling an afternoon crash and I really need to power through it, nothing is anywhere near as effective as a cold shower. Boosts my mood, wakes me up. Be forewarned, it's rather intense. If you're not used to it, make sure you don't have any medical conditions that would interfere with it. If you're frail or you have a slippy shower floor and you could get surprised and go on and fall, take proper precautions. But a cold shower is a great way to wake up from a crash. And hey, desperate times call for desperate measures. Now, there's a few tips that I have that maybe you don't want to hear, but I'm going to give them anyway. Number one, sleep more. I think a lot of us aren't sleeping well and we're not sleeping enough. And we may feel that we have so much to do, we just can't afford to sleep the one or two extra hours in the morning that our bodies are telling us it wants. But part of the reason that we have an afternoon crash is because we have cumulative sleep pressure that's building and we're not sleeping enough to get rid of it. So while the cold shower and the meal that I recommended may help, we still need to address the fundamentals, and that's sleeping enough and sleeping well. Number two, take a nap. Maybe you don't want to hear that because you want to be really productive in the afternoon. Maybe your boss doesn't want you to hear that because your boss doesn't want you taking a nap in the office, but still, hey, if you're sleepy in the afternoon, that's your body telling you to take a nap. So I think it's great to try to design meals and to try to design showers around powering through the afternoon nap. And yeah, when I'm working on a creative project, I want to power through it, but I don't think we should always be trying to power through every time that our body makes us feel sleepy. At some point, we need to say, hey, I powered through it enough. Now I'm going to start giving the body the rest that it needs. And that's when, at least some of the time, you want to take a nap when your body's telling you it wants a nap. And the last tip is, have a cup of coffee. Well, I mean, maybe you wanted to hear that, but maybe it didn't help that much because you probably were already doing that. But hey, I love coffee, so have a cup of coffee. All right, that's it. You've been watching Chris Masterjohn Lite. I will see you in the next video.